Adding a server to be monitored or managed through Enterprise Manager is a relatively straightforward process. Using the navigation panel on the left, select servers to see a list of already added systems, then click Add Server. This page defaults to adding one server, but there are some other options at the top of the page we will address as well. Select if you wish the connection to be made via inbound or outbound connection. Selecting inbound will prompt you to enter the IP address of the system you wish to add. The Enterprise Manager software will reach out to the address to try to find a server at that address. This requires a pathway into that network where the server lies. In some instances, due to network configuration or firewall setup, an inbound connection may be difficult to achieve. When attempting an outbound connection, the server will be initiating the connection by reaching out to the Enterprise Manager to begin the communication. This removes the requirement to configure an inbound firewall rule on your router. You will need to configure the outbound communication page on the recording server with the address of your Enterprise Manager to complete the connection. Your server will need outbound access on port 35111 to allow it to reach the Enterprise Manager instance. Enter a port number. This is similar to connecting a workstation client instance to the server, and therefore the default port number 22609 is the same. Add your credentials in the username and password field for logging into that server. As a reminder from the video on creating groups, every server must be a member of a group. Select the group this server will become a logical member of. The optional hostname field may be used to enter a fully qualified domain name if using a dynamic DNS. The web service menu enables a video connection using a web service. You have some options to choose from. No web service will not attempt to connect to a web service for this system. Create new web service adds a system's web service to the Enterprise Manager configuration. You will enter the connection details and password to access it. You may need this option if the web service for a particular system runs on a machine other than the server you are adding. Select Existing Web Service displays a list of previously configured web services to choose from. In cases where a single web service provides video from multiple ExacqVision NVRs, you may need to select this. Discover Web Service attempts to locate web services on the network for you to select from. Use Server Address and Credentials assumes there is a web service running on the NVR, and the credentials for the web service are the same as those to log into the server. Using the file selector, you have the option to upload a picture of the server to make locating the system easier for those administering the system in the future. This could just be a picture of what the system looks like, or a picture of where it is in your server rack. If checking the Enable Live Streaming box, this allows Enterprise Manager to stream live video. Enterprise Manager should not be used as a permanent viewing station interface, but this feature allows you to check camera field of views as well as use the inspection tool we will look at in another video. The connection heartbeat sets the number of seconds between the heartbeat messages exchanged between the servers and Enterprise Manager, which allow Enterprise Manager to check that each system is still online and connected. Lastly, there is an additional data field for entering any extra information you may want to refer to about the system in the future. Returning to the top of the page, there is also an option to bulk add servers. Using the ExacqVision desktop client, export your list of servers to an XDV file. You may then upload this file, entering login credentials and the group each server will belong to. A third option exists to add systems using Discover Servers. This will list servers that Enterprise Manager found running on the same network segment. This option will not be able to discover server instances outside of your network, perhaps at another building, unless on the same subnet through something like a VPN. Newly added systems will now appear in the list when returning to the servers page.